Now every gambler knows the secret to surviving is knowing what to throw away, knowing what to keep. 'Cause every hand's a winner and every hand's a loser, and the best you can hope for is to die.
All right, welcome to ongoing coverage of our media wars. Now we're going to cover 1902. We've covered 1901. We've seen our power rankings, but just so you can see here, we are at four. We are at war with Russia here. We're at war with Austria here. Italy's promised to help. I guess big question for me is, whose side is Germany on? Is Germany not going to fight England? We know what France has to do. France might get brushed back, but there's a lot of little issues here. I'm a little surprised this build by Bob. I might build an army and send it to Belgium if I'm Bob. But okay. So what are the goals going into 1902?
Well, figure out how I can keep Bulgaria and everything safe as much as possible. So it's going to be a turn, two turns, maybe three turns before Italy can really do anything. Because if they stab right away, everything can be kicked out too. So my main goal in the spring is just to move Kondogian and give my Bulgarian army a place to retreat. I think if I move...
So you think they're coming after Bulgaria and not Black with that second fleet?
Well, if I cut Romania with Bulgaria and Sevastopol with Armenia, Black's not going anywhere. So I can rotate Khan out if I want to. Right. I get intel from Cedric, since he's in the air, that they actually are not going after Bulgaria and they are rotating out. And so that's why I cut it. I was going to do it regardless, just because I would have a retreat and would keep me from losing too much, but...
So you feel Cedric's on side, and am I right that France is just going to fight England here? What's your read on Germany?
France doesn't know what's going on, because everyone seems to be really hostile. He's got Italy on them. Germany didn't do anything, but he's got England and Brest. And so he's like, I just want Brest back, and I'm just going to hang out until I figure out what I need. So he's not anyone.
I'm almost, if I'm England, convoying Brest to Belgium. It's more defensive.
Right here, I tell Bob to move north to Holland and bounce Germany again and get Brest up Belgium. And he's like, oh, it's like you read my orders. He doesn't do that, which is dumb.
So now he's in. Okay. All right. So let's look at who we care about. You saved everything. They didn't go for Bulgaria. You prevented Austria from getting Gian. You didn't lose Black. Cedric got into Adriatic and Tyrolia. This is huge. And he goes to Ione. And even better for you that army is sort of stranded.
Yep.
Okay, that's good. I really like these Captain Meme orders. I might have gone to Mid-Atlantic here. Other than that.
Mid-Atlantic would have covered everything just fine. I think you want to be able to be sure he could take Brest and Marseille back and moved in.
Bob here makes some errors, right? He couldn't prevent Norway.
No.
He's decided to fight on the continent, but there's that fleet built north coast, which is really good for Germany. On the other hand, Germany built, I don't know, it's all very curious. But from your perspective, things had to go well spring 19. I couldn't imagine a better thing.
I was reveling in that. I thought their play was a little defensive, but
Now tell me for fall, what are you thinking? Because there's a lot of options here, right? There's Greece. There's the potential convoy.
I can't do Greece. Well, yeah, there's Greece.
But it probably wouldn't work. But Cedric can put Trieste under threat. What are you attempting to do?
Cedric leaks me what they're going to do, and we make plans around their plans, so we know exactly what to do.
All right, well, then let's look at.
So I know Bulgaria's under threat because Greece is getting tapped. So even if Greece moves out, the convoy comes in. I wasn't too worried about losing a gene.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I guess Serbia could have covered it in that scenario, but it seems more likely that Bulgaria. So in the world of, what's good for Keith, it's really good for Cedric, right, that he walks in. It's not even bounced by Vienna. It's sane, by the way. That Austria didn't make that move, at least with one. I mean, honestly, if it's me, I'm probably self-bounced. And he gets Marcus to help him into Munich, which I sort of love. Right. I mean, what's going on? And first of all, why are they working with Cedric? He moved an army to Tyrolia and Adriatic and Ionian. Why are they working with him?
After Cedric wanted to pivot, he DMZ'd the entire thing. And so they're on side, because France had no allies. I mean, Germany's neutral to France. England's impressed. And so France is just looking for anything he can get. And right now he's got Italy.
And France is
Because there's a
helping.
GR.
There's a GR. France is sort of helping because he doesn't really want to fight England right now, or maybe he wants England to get a little more committed. He got Brest back.
Yeah, this is the French English makeup right here. It's like, I'm just gonna leave Brest and then I'll exit channel as soon as I can. We'll just push forward. And so I think this is France being on board, being like, well, Italy can take this for sure, and it's easy to take from Italy later. It's harder for Italy to.
So the big winner here is Cedric, but I'm going to put you as second.
Pretty good too. I mean, knocking everyone down, getting.
All right. So what does we get an army and a fleet? Oh, and the fleet Marseille.
He needed
So
another fleet. He only had one, and that's the only
we had no
vote.
place to build. But Cedric's not building in Naples. He's very.
Yeah, he doesn't build in Naples.
Is
No,
that what he told you, or is that just like?
it just happened to work that way. He has never built in Naples. It
Okay, that's curious.
is a very interesting thing. I don't know why, but yeah, he has not built in Naples one.
All right, so now we're going to our 1902 power rank. You're still number one in my book. I like your position. I gotta still put Cedric as number two for you at the end
Yep.
of 1902. I don't know. Where are we with the others?
France is
Who are we?
pretty neutral. Germany's pretty neutral. I think Germany almost invited Italy in there anyways, because they're talking about doing a pass through. That's Cedric's favorite move is Munich to Burgundy.
Okay, and where are we with the last?
Bob, I'm still trying to work with. Obviously now he's under attack by Russia, which he created that monster. So I mean, Bob's pretty high. I'm trying to keep him alive as much as possible because he is a big, big decoy. I'd rather
And
everyone look over there.
I'm thinking Russia's
Russia
gotta be
doesn't
the.
trust me. Russia doesn't talk to me. He does talk to me, but then he's just like, he just can't. And there's no reason for him to.
I think you need to do these differently. Austria is like your friend by leaking all those orders. I'm putting Austria as third helpful to you.
It's pretty true.
And Russia is currently the big enemy
Yep.
at the end of 1902. Is that fair?
That's very, very fair. Because this is the way I paint 1903.
All right.
For a taste of your whiskey, I'll give you some advice. You got to know when to hold up. Know when to fold up. Know when to walk away. Know when to run. You never count your money. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done.